mate. There's bound to be more blokes wanting to get out on the street.
Yeah, all the good ones are out there already. Who needs more pen pushers on the street? Looks a bit young for that kind of motor. Let's get a PNC.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 3.
Sierra Oscar receiving, go ahead, Mike.
PNC check, please, Norica. Silver grey VW Golf. Registration number Hotel 945 Hotel Hotel Foxtrot.
Received.
Seatbelt's just gone on.
Could be the parents' car.
My old man wouldn't even let me borrow his push bike.
Silver grey Golf, Hotel 945 Hotel Hotel Foxtrot. Registered keeper shown as Terence Cam, 31 Apton Park Road. No trace lost or stolen, Mike.
I think we'll take a little look anyway, see if he has got a rich daddy. Come on, don't be a prat. Not daddy's in.
Sierra Oscar from Oscar 3.
Go ahead.
We're following Silver Grey Golf GTI, Hotel 945 Hotel Hotel Foxtrot into Rutkin Road. Watch out, there's a bump in the road.
Any chance of any assistance? This thing's all up to it.
Golf bearing left onto Purchase Road.
Assistance requested.
Sierra Oscar 3 from Sierra 1. We're on way, Mike. ETA, 2 minutes.
You reckon Boyden got bored?
Golf heading east on Maidle Street. Must be doing 60, or we can't keep up.
MP from Sierra 1, suspect vehicle, Silver Grey Golf, now in sight. Taking over pursuit, heading east on Maydell Street.
MP received, other unit, break off.
MP from Sierra 1, he's just run the lights at the Tello Street crossing, doing 60.
65, he's breaking now, he's going right, right,
and now he's left, left, left into Bradley. No, no, right into Brockhurst Road, heading towards Maydell Street again. Don't mind me.
Sorry.
He's all over the place, he's touching 70. Middle of the road, he's breaking hard for a bend. He's lost it! MP from Sierra 1, suspect vehicle has crashed 1 mile east on Brockhurst Road.
Received Sierra 1.
Ambulance, Dave. This one's in a bad way.
Sierra Oscar receiving.
Ambulance required, Brockhurst Road, serious RTA.
Received, Dave.
Sierra Oscar 3 from Sierra Oscar.
Receiving.
Yeah, Matt, the area car's had a vicinity only Pollack. Can you deal?
All right, love, don't try and move. We'll have you out of here soon. Tell me your name. Can you do that?
Karen Logan, 11 Brookman Drive.
All right, Karen, you'll be fine.
Yeah, driver looked like Gavin Crane, lives on the Omcombe. Did his younger brother about 6 months ago for doing car radios.
Yeah, runs in the family. Start with the radios, move up to the whole car. But you go with them, I'll get someone to tell the parents if they're interested.
All right, Sarge.
Index Charlie 807. Victor Alpha Alpha. Okay, enough of the sightseeing. Come on, move on.
Casing's okay, it's just the glass that's gone.
Keep it quiet, Eddie.
What for? We've got to go back out again when we come off shift. And Paul Tyler's not going to take the blame for it, is he?
And square it with him. Oh, come on, Dave, it's just till tomorrow. Quick changeover, we're back on at 6, I'll get it done then. If I report it, it's a Pollack, another one, just for a little bit of glass.
You two okay?
Yeah, fine, Sarge, no problem.
Dave?
Yeah, fine, Sarge.
Right, we're getting finished here and we'll sort the paperwork out when you've done.
All right, proving. How do you mean, Sarge?
No dents.
Terence Cam?
Yes?
Sergeant Boyden, son ill. I'm sorry to bother you, but according to our records, you're the registered keeper of a Golf GTI. Registration H945HF. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right. It's just down the road.
I'm afraid it's not down the road anymore, sir. Can I come in?
Yes. What's happened?
I'm afraid your vehicle was involved in an accident, sir. The driver's behaviour gave us cause for suspicion, and when he didn't stop, one of our cars gave chase. I'm afraid your car left the road. It was being driven without your permission.
Well, yes, I thought it was just outside.
Anyone else use the car?
Yeah, my wife, Stephanie, she drives it if her Fiat's playing up, no one else.
So when was the last time you saw the Golf?
Well, I washed it at about 5. And then I came in, I put Charlie to bed.
Your son?
Yes, yes. It must have been there at 6, though. That's when Stephanie went out. She'd have noticed if it was gone.
Right.
Is it totally written off?
Well, I'm no mechanic, but it hit another car, and it didn't do either of them much good.
And the passengers?
Not good, I'm afraid. A couple of teenagers.
I know the sort. I have to teach them. Elmcombe Secondary.
PC Jarvis?
Yep. Mr. and Mrs. Clark?
Yes. One of your officers came and said Karen was here. Karen Logan. We are her foster parents.
What happened? All he would say was a road accident.
Well, we haven't got all the facts yet, but Karen was a passenger in what we think was a stolen car. It crashed while one of our vehicles was in pursuit, and both Karen and the driver were injured.
You mean the police car hit it?
No, the driver just lost control.
Do you know how she is? Because the nurse just said she's still being examined.
Well, I'm afraid not. Doctor won't be too long. Why don't you come over here and I'll take some more details, yeah?
So, what do I do now? About the car, I mean. I'll call the insurance company, but do I need to get it towed away or will you do that?
I'm afraid it's your responsibility to get it moved, sir.
Do you know if Decker's and Bream Road are open on a Sunday?
I think so.
I reckon they get a tow truck.
State it's in, you'll need one. Sorry.
Is Karen friends with the driver? Gavin Crane. He lives on the Elmcombe.
She never mentioned him, but she did used to live near there before she came to us. How is she?
She's going to be fine. She cut her head on the windscreen, got quite a lot of bruising from the impact. Nothing that won't fade in time. We're going to keep her in overnight, just for observation.
What about the driver?
Not so fortunate. 2 broken legs, a punctured lung, and a fractured skull are the most immediate of the injuries.
Has he come round?
Not yet. To be honest, he's pretty lucky to be alive.
Doctor, we want to see Gavin. Gavin Crane.
Matt, what's the situation with the Pollack?
Just writing out now, sir. Definitely a TDA. As far as the owner was concerned, it was outside his house, freshly washed.
And the crash?
Still vicinity only. The aero car gave pursuit, but they didn't make contact. So there's no question of them being involved in the crash. The kid just couldn't handle it.
What's new? Idiots.
There is one more thing, sir. I had to 54 the Panda.
Oh.
We hit a couple of speed bumps. The exhaust is gone.
During the pursuit?
Well, yes, there was nothing I could do about it.
Well, at least it's not Steve Loxton again. That's something, I suppose.
Oh, Matt, the exhaust could be just wear and tear, yes?
Definitely. Must have been going for ages.
Right.
So I'm supposed to drive the whole shift with only one mirror?
Well, they're not going to fix it tonight anyway, are they? Look, I'm back on at 6. I'll whip it around to Joe's Deckers and get it done.
Out of your own pocket?
What's it going to be? 10, 15 quid? Better that than another Pollack report on Monroe's desk.
How many this month, then?
Enough. So?
All right.
Cheers, mate.
If anyone spots it, I'm not taking the blame.
That's fine. Thanks, Paul.
You must be off your head. What if Monroe finds out and you haven't reported it?
He won't.
All right, it's your neck.
Yeah, well, I don't have very far to travel. No, straight home, to bed, and then back here again like this morning.
Oi! Am I going to see somebody or what?
Good morning, sir. How can we help you?
I want to make a complaint. Last night, one of your drivers ran my boy off the road, and I want him done for it.
Oh, I see, sir. And you are?
Stan Crane.
Well, Mr. Crane, if you'd just like to take a seat for a minute, I'll get Inspector Monroe to come and have a word with you.
So you have got one?
Yeah, only because I ordered it last week.
It's for a customer.
Look, can't you order another one? Tell them they're hard to come by. Oh, come on, George, I mean, stuck otherwise. Look, there's a drink in it, OK?
You want it done now, do you?
It's only going to take you 5 minutes. How much?
All right. 20, and that's retail.
20? Last time it was 15.
Hey, George, the golf over there. Is he owner, Benny?
No. He phoned last night for us to tow it. It was Joyriders. You lot chased them.
Yeah, yeah, I know. How do you think we got the mirror? Why is it locked?
No reason. Except to stop the kids round here from having a go. There you are, if you want to get inside.
Where'd you get this?
The ignition.
What, they hadn't wired it?
No.
There you go, 20.
So, boy, what about the drink? Thank you.
They were chasing him, weren't they? Sirens going, the whole lot.
Chasing, yes, but what...
Well, it stands to reason then, doesn't it? If they hadn't been chasing him, he wouldn't have crashed.
If Gavin hadn't been driving a stolen car, we wouldn't have had to chase him. He brought this on himself.
Yeah, well, that's all right for you to say. It's not your kid lying in hospital, is it?
You better not be thinking they're charging him, that's all. Otherwise.
Mr. Crane, you know as well as I do that Gavin's been nicking cars since he was 12. You probably taught him how. This time he caught up with him, and he's no one to blame but himself.
You understand the caution, Karen? For the tape, please.
Yes.
You know the form. What happened last night?
Sergeant, I know Karen had problems in the past, but it is in the past now.
Well, that's what we're here to find out. So why don't you start by telling me where you got the car from?
I don't know. Gavin saw me walk in and stopped to give me a lift.
You and Gavin are friends?
No, not really. I used to be at school with him before I went to Ken and Marlene's.
So before he picked you up, when was the last time you saw him?
I don't know, maybe a year ago.
Did he have a car then?
No, he was only 16.
Well, you must have thought he was doing really well to have a car like that then.
I don't know, I didn't think about it. I suppose I just thought it was his.
You didn't ask?
No. I'm not interested in cars. I mean, I didn't even know what sort it was.
Come on, Karen. Gavin is a young urban layabout. I don't really believe you thought that car was his.
All right, maybe I did think it was nicked. But I was in a hurry. I was late for my babysitting.
So?
Oh, no. I just remembered. I should have rung them last night.
Sorry, rung who?
The Cams. The people Karen babysits for. They won't know why she didn't turn up last night.
Wait a minute. Do you mean Terry and Stephanie Cam, Mapton Park Road?
Yes. That's right. Why?
Karen?
I don't know what you're talking about.
The stolen car belonged to Mr. Cam. Don't tell me you didn't recognise it.
No. I told you, I'm not interested in cars. They all look the same.
Well, you must have seen Terry Cam's car loads of times.
Yeah, so? Look, I told you, Gavin stopped to give me a lift. That's all.
So it was a pure coincidence he'd just been out and nicked that particular car, was it?
Yeah.
You didn't have anything to do with it?
No.
I don't believe you. Now, why don't you tell me what really happened?
Look, I didn't know the car was Terry's, and I didn't know it was nicked. I didn't do anything, and you can't prove I did.
Right, we'll have to talk to you again when we've heard what Gavin has to say.
He'll only tell you what I told you. He'd just give me a lift.
Well, we'll see, won't we?
Sergeant, there's a chance that all this could be a coincidence.
Chance, yeah, but not a very big one.
I know Karen used to be a tearaway, but she settled down now. For the last couple of years, she hasn't put a foot wrong. Does this have to spoil it all for her?
Well, she told the truth. See what you can do.
I'll try.
A bit early for rest, didn't you?
I thought we'd come in while it was quiet, Sarge.
Sarge, I don't know if you're interested, but we had a look at that golf earlier. It's down at George Decker's place.
Oh, yeah? What are you doing down there?
We were just passing.
You spent any time on patrol this morning?
Well, the thing is that the owner of the golf must have left it with a key in, because George says it was in the ignition when he towed it.
Sure, it's the right key for the car. Not something old Gavin's bunged in the lock on the off chance.
No, it's the right key, because it fits all the doors. I mean, it's going to make a bit of a difference to his insurance claim, though, isn't it? The owner, I mean.
Yeah. Thanks, Dave.
Oh, Matthew, what did the girl say, Gavin's passenger?
Karen? She says she just accepted the lift, didn't know the car was stolen. It turns out she babysits for the owner.
Terence Cam?
Yeah, teacher at Elkham Secondary. If it's okay with you, I'd like to go over there and talk to him again, see what he has to say about Karen.
Okay, but you better call the headmaster and clear it. His pupils aren't exactly lining up to take the Met's entrance exams.
Right.
To be frank, Sergeant, having the police inside the school makes a lot of these kids feel they're under surveillance.
Yes, sir, but on the other hand, people don't usually commit crimes if they think they're being watched.
Terry. Sergeant Boyden.
Hello, Sergeant. What can I do for you?
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Kemp. I need to ask you a couple more questions about last night.
Will you show Sergeant Boyden out when you've finished, Terry? Sergeant.
Thank you. Are you about to get invaded?
No. I've got half an hour's respite before my next class.
Right. Well, the thing is, I've just talked to the girl who was a passenger in your car after it was stolen.
Mm-hmm.
Her name's Karen Logan.
Karen? Was that... Well, I don't understand.
She's your babysitter?
Yes. She was going to come round last night until I changed my mind about going out.
So you called it off?
That's right, but look, Karen never struck me as the type who'd get involved in joyriding.
How would you describe her?
Ah. I know she's had a bit of a rocky childhood. She's been in and out of care, but since I've known her, she's always been very responsible. My wife and I both like her. We wouldn't have had her as a babysitter otherwise.
The youth who was driving your car is called Gavin Crane. Do you know him?
Well, if it's the same one, he was a pupil here until about 18 months ago. A troublemaker.
In what way?
Well, we had a couple of run-ins after an outbreak of vandalism. In the end, he was suspended.
By you?
No, I can't do that. I sometimes wish I could. Now, he's one of those who doesn't want to learn and wants to stop everyone else as well.
So he might have had a grudge against you after all these run-ins.
Oh, I suppose so. Oh, I see what you mean. You think he took the car to get back at me?
Well, it's possible. We also found a key in the car after it crashed. So unless you left it in the ignition...
No, all my keys are on my keyring.
What about spares?
Well, there's one at home for Stephanie.
Do you keep it where someone could have got at it?
All the keys are all together. They're hung up in the kitchen, but I don't see why Karen would take them. Gavin Crane might have a grudge against me, but not Karen. She's a nice girl.
What's that?
Gavin came round about half an hour ago. The doctor won't let me see him yet. I'm not sure when he's going to be up for talking.
Parents are in?
Yeah, mother and brother, but...
You won't have nothing to say to you.
Who are you?
Mark, Gavin's brother. What's it to you?
Hold on, I want to talk to you.
Tough, my mum needs a cup of tea.
Yeah, in a minute. Has Gavin ever spoken about a teacher of his, Mr. Cam?
No.
Never said he wanted to get even, maybe Nicky's car?
No, and if he had, I wouldn't tell you, would I? Anyway, you can't drop all this on our Gav. It was her as well.
Who?
That Karen, she was with him. She'd be doing her and all.
With him when? In the car?
Leave it out. She was with him when he left our house and didn't have no car then. She's as much in this as Gav. Now, you can let me get a tea or what?
Cheers. So what about Karen, Mrs. Cam? Could she have taken a spare key?
Well, she could. It was hanging up here with all the rest, but I know she wouldn't.
Well, it's gone, so someone must have taken it.
Not Karen.
Well, you know she was starting to get in trouble with the police a few years ago.
Yes, but that's before she went to live with Ken and Marlene. I've known her since then. She's never had a moment's trouble.
Well, it's possible that Gavin Crane pressurised her into taking the key. Sort of thing he'd do.
No, if anyone had been bothering her, she would have told me. I suppose I'm a bit like an older sister for her. She tells me things. You know, girls talk. Who she fancies, what she's worried about.
So she never mentioned Gavin Crane?
Never. And besides, why would you help him take the car to steal from us? I'm sorry, there has to be another explanation.
He's lively. How old is he?
19 months. And a real mischief, aren't you?
Did you work for you, Adam?
Yes, the gas showrooms. I should go back when Charlie's a bit older.
Do you know, I saw somewhere it takes £100,000 to bring up a kid till they're 18.
Is that all? Costs a fortune just to keep you in nappies, doesn't it? Still worth it, aren't you?
All right, Karen. And this time I want you to tell me the truth.
I've told you.
No, you haven't. Let's start with the key, shall we?
What key?
The car key. The spare to Terry Cam's Golf that you took from the kitchen. It was found in the car after it crashed.
I didn't take it. I don't know anything about it.
So what about the fact you were at Gavin's house yesterday evening?
I wasn't. I told you. He stopped to give me a lift, that's all.
No, he didn't. You went to call for him. Then you both left his house on foot. You were seen. How long's he been your boyfriend?
Oh, he isn't. I don't even like him.
I think he is. I think you had that key on you when you went to call for him. You wanted Gavin to steal that car because you don't like Terry and Stephanie, do you?
No, I do like them.
Well, you've got a funny way of showing it. They invite you into their home, welcome your trust, and you betrayed that trust.
No, I didn't. I didn't want to take the car.
Sergeant.
Well, what was it then? You were trying to help them. Is that it? Well, tell me about it. Whose idea was it? Gavin's? Stephanie's?
No, Terry's. He said no one would know. He said it wouldn't hurt anyone. Just the insurance company.
Well, what did he want you to do?
He said I could find someone. He said I'd know the right person. Someone who'd take the car and set fire to it, like it was Joyriders. He said he'd give him £100 from the insurance money. I didn't want to do it.
Well, why did you?
Terry said Stephanie was worried about money, that they'd had loads of red bills and only his wages. The car insurance had gone up and he couldn't afford it anymore.
Did Stephanie know about all this?
No.
All right. So what happened yesterday evening?
He phoned and said Stephanie had gone out and the car was parked on the road. The key was tied under the back bumper.
So you went to fetch Gavin and you took the car. Why did you go in the car with him?
Terry said I should. To make sure he set fire to it. And then the police car tried to stop us and Gavin just... I thought he was going to die. I mean, we could have.
Mr. Cam, can you come down to the station, please? I've just talked to Karen. She's made a new statement.
Well, that's good, I suppose, but I don't see how I can help.
Terry, what's the... Oh, hello.
Mrs. Cam, Karen alleges you asked her to find someone to nick the car and burn it.
Well, and you believe her? Well, come on, that's ridiculous. Why would I do that?
The golf must be worth several £1,000. No doubt you could use the insurance money.
Look, Sergeant, with the best will in the world, you can't be taking this seriously. I like Karen, she's a nice girl, but I also know her background. So must you. As for Gavin Crane, well, I'm sorry, this is just a waste of time.
Sir.
Look!
Terence Cam, I'm arresting you on suspicion of conspiracy to obtain money by deception. You do not have to say anything unless you wish to do so, or what you say may be given in evidence. Do you understand?
Yes, but hold on.
Terry!
Then will you come with me, please?
Sir, I want my solicitor informed.
You can do it from the station.
Who do you think's going to listen to a couple of delinquent teenagers?
Since they were both nearly killed, quite a few, I reckon.
It's still their word against mine.
In court, maybe. But insurance companies are great ones for making up their own minds. They get the slightest idea that you've been trying to defraud them, they'll keep you dangling in the breeze. No car, no money, no sympathy. Mind you, Ed.